Hello and welcome. My name's George, and my channel is all about helping you get the most out of Logic Pro so that you can record and produce your best music in your home studio. Today, we're going to be looking at flex pitch, which allows you to tune and time your vocals in Logic Pro. We'll look at all the different features and options found within flex pitch, and then I'll show you exactly how to go about tuning your vocals. So let's dive in. Okay, so here in my session, I've got my comped vocals right here. And so what we're going to do in order to access flex pitch is first we need to show flex. So to do that, you go up here to this little icon right here, which you can also open up by hitting the hotkey command F. And then once you do that, you'll see this little pull down list here. And these are the different flex algorithms that are available to us. At the moment, we have flex time selected and monophonic. So that would be if we're doing any timing adjustments to a monophonic instrument. In this case, we're dealing with voice, so we want to select flex pitch. And we can do some timing adjustments within flex pitch as well. So we'll select flex pitch. And you saw that Logic analyzed all the different regions. And then as well, it also enabled flex pitch. So you can see that this is now lit up in blue, whereas these ones are gray because we have flex pitch turned off on these ones. Now, one of the first things I recommend you do before you get into the flex pitch is to actually join all these different regions. If you've done a comp and you have a bunch of different regions like I do, I find that the flex pitch works a lot better if it's just dealing with one continuous audio file. So for that, all we need to do is get our glue tool up here, select all our regions, and then simply click with the glue tool. Now Logic will ask us if we want to create a new file, which we do, so we'll hit create. And now we have one continuous file. And now to open the flex pitch editor, I'm just going to double click on my region. And that opens that up here. Now I can make this a little bit bigger so it's easier to see. And so you see here we have our waveform. And if I scroll down a little bit, you'll see we have all these blue blocks. And these blue blocks correspond to the different pitches of our vocal. So you can see here there's our piano notes on the left here. So each of these blocks correspond to a different note. So let me just set up a loop here and start by soloing my vocal. So first I'll just play a little bit of the vocal so you can hear what it sounds like.
I never meant to hurt you. Never meant to keep you in the dark. I never meant to hurt you. Should've known we were wrong right from the start.
So there's the raw vocal there. So before we get to actually tuning the vocal, I'm going to show you the different tools that you have available to you in flex pitch. So let me just zoom in on this one phrase. So first off, as I mentioned, we have these little blocks here. And you'll notice that there is some solid blue here and a little bit of transparent blue at the bottom. And on this one, a little bit at the top and at the bottom, and then a little bit at the bottom there as well. And then this one is mostly solid. So when we see a little bit of transparency, that's Logic saying that the pitch has drifted a little bit. So there's two ways we can adjust the pitch. We can simply grab this block and move it up and down, which will move it in semitones. Or we can do a fine tune. So if you go to this little arrow here in the middle on the top, you'll see it says fine pitch. And right now it's at minus 19. So now if I drag up, then it's going to move it up in a lot more fine increments. And once we're at zero, you'll see that this block is all solid blue now, and therefore Logic perceives this as being in tune. We can also simply just double click on a block and that'll just snap it to the closest pitch as well. Now, each of these other points here have their own function as well. So if we go to the first one in the top left, you'll see it says pitch drift. So this controls the scoops into the note and as well as out. So a lot of times singers, as you can see here, will scoop into the note. And if you want to counteract that a little bit or make it more drastic, you can do that using the pitch drift. So for example, here, I can make it a more drastic scoop, or I can counteract that and make it scoop from the top, for example.
Never meant.
Instead of scoop from below.
Never meant.
And you also have the same thing on the top right. We can do that.
Never meant.
And I can simply undo by going Command Z. Next, we have gain. So gain just simply adjusts the volume of each of these blocks. So it's usually done in pitches, right? So let's say there's one word that's quieter than the rest. For example, this word right here, we could bring the gain up just for that one word. So this can be handy if there's a few words that get lost in the mix a little bit. And without the need for compressing it a lot, you can just kind of boost those little words that way. Next we have vibrato. Now vibrato can be used to tame the tuning a little bit. So for example, if there's some spots that get a little too out, what you can do is use the vibrato to kind of flatten it out a little bit. So for example, if I wanted to flatten this curve a little bit, I could use the vibrato and flatten it out like that. And then now at the same time, you see that that raises that drift a little bit. So now we could bring that drift down here. And now we flatten that curve a little bit. You can also use it at the end of phrases where you see there's kind of some natural vibrato happening. If we wanted to increase it, we could do that. Or as I said before, we can flatten it out. Now the vibrato is one thing to be a little bit careful with, because if you go too flat, then that's when it's going to sound a little bit robotic and it's going to sound heavily tuned. But that sound can also be used as a creative effect. And then the last one is the formant shift. So this is actually going to change the character of the voice. So I'll zoom out a little bit and let's do this whole phrase. We'll just change the formant of this whole phrase. So again, the original sounds like this.
Never meant to hurt you.
And if I bring up the formant, it's going to make everything sound a bit like a chipmunk.
I never meant to hurt you.
Or you can do the opposite effect and bring it down. And that's going to lower the quality of the voice.
I never meant to hurt you.
So again, that can be used as a creative effect. Now, the other thing I mentioned earlier is that you can do some timing things in flex pitch as well. So you can actually resize any of these blocks just by grabbing the corners. And you'll see that'll move and lengthen the note. So as I lengthen one, it'll compress the other.
Never meant to hurt you.
So that way you can change the phrasing a little bit or tighten some things up if the singer came in too early or was a little bit late. So now that we know the different tools available to us, let's go ahead and tune a little bit of this vocal. So the first thing I generally do is select all the notes I want to tune. So I can either select a big range to start, or if I just want to select everything in one go, I can go Command A. And then up here, where it says pitch correction, I can simply drag this. And if I wanted to go to 100%, I just drag this to 100. And you notice everything snapped to the closest semitone. And a few other options you can do is you can actually quantize it based on scale. So down here, we have our scale quantize. If, for example, this song is in C major, we select C. Now it'll move all those notes to pitches in the C major scale. If I change this to minor, for example, then you see those notes move once again. I'm going to turn the scale quantize off, and those will go back again to the closest pitch. So at this point, what I usually do is listen back, and if there's anything that sounds out or if it got pushed to the wrong pitch, then I'll make that change.
I never meant to hurt you, never meant to keep you.
So there's one note that missed the mark a little bit. It should be a little bit higher.
Never meant to keep you in.
And you can see again that there's this scoop and the note actually gets higher. So actually on this note, what I usually do is chop this in half. So I would take my scissor tool and go to where the note rises. So right here, and I'll just chop that in half and you'll see how that jumped up, right? And now let's see how that sounds.
Meant to keep you.
So that's better. That's what I want.
Keep you in the dark.
And then a similar thing here is this note should be lower down like this one. So I'm going to do the same thing. I'm just going to chop that note there. And then even that one out there, even that out. And actually, I might make another chop there.
Keep you in the dark. You in the dark. I never meant to.
And now this is a spot where it gets a little unruly as well.
I never meant to hurt you.
You can see that jumps up there.
Never meant to hurt you. Never meant to hurt. Never meant to hurt you. Never meant to hurt you.
So this is a spot where we needed to chop up the note a little bit more to make it fit to where we wanted to go, because the pitch kind of jumps around quite a bit.
Never meant to hurt you. Should have known we were wrong right from the start.
Now this is another spot that we need to do a little bit of fixing.
Should have known we were wrong. Should have known we.
This should be a little bit higher.
Should have known we were wrong, right? Should have known we were wrong, right from the. Should have known we were wrong, right from.
And this one should chop so that that can come down a little bit.
Should have known we were wrong, right from the start.
And this one too, we can probably chop that. It can come down a bit.
Should have known we were wrong, right?
And this is probably somewhere where we can adjust the vibrato a bit to bring that down.
Should have known we were wrong, right from the start. Oh, oh, oh. Yeah, we were wrong, right from the.
And similarly here, let's tweak this a little bit.
Yeah, we were wrong.
Chop that. And this one too, let's take the vibrato out a little bit to flatten that one.
Yeah, we were wrong, right? Yeah, we were wrong, right from. Yeah, we were wrong, right from those.
And then this drift, we can maybe bring that a bit down.
Right from the start. From the start. Oh. Now you're running away with my heart.
So there's a little section done. And of course, we can get a lot more nitpicky and go through and change the timing. Let's just have a listen to that with the track.
I never meant to hurt you. Never meant to keep you in the dark. I never meant to hurt you. Should've known we were wrong right from the start. Oh, oh, oh. Yeah, we were wrong right from the
So there you go. So that's how you do some tuning using Flex Pitch and Logic Pro. And now our vocal is all ready to be mixed with the rest of our track. If you have any more questions, feel free to leave those in the comments. And if you want to improve your workflow in Logic Pro, don't forget to download my free Logic Pro hotkey cheat sheet by following the link in the description below. I hope you enjoyed the video, and we'll see you in the next one.